previous video, we established this theorem here. Suppose x and y are independent random variables, and let w equal x plus y. Then the PDF for w is equal to the integral from negative infinity to infinity of the PDF for x times the PDF for y with w minus x plugged in, and all integrated with respect to x. So last video we talked about the discrete case, now we're just going to focus in this video on the continuous case. So let's do an example to think about this one. So let's have two uniform distributions. X is going to be uniformly distributed between 0 and 1, and then y is also going to be uniformly distributed between 0 and 1. And then x is going to be independent of y. So we're going to find the PDF for w, which is equal to x plus y. So before we dive into applying this theorem here, let's note a couple things. So first of all, where is our PDF going to be positive? Well, our PDF for x is positive for x values between 0 and 1. And our PDF for y is positive for y values between 0 and 1. So since w is equal to x plus y, the smallest value that w can take on is 0, and the biggest value that w can take on is 2. So w is going to take on values in the interval 0 to 2. OK, so now that we've established w must be between 0 and 2, let's also think just like intuitively about what we expect this PDF to look like. So since x is uniform and y is uniform, then for the values between 0 and 2, what values are going to be more likely and what values are going to be less likely? So if we think about some value of w really close to 0, there's not a ton of ways that we can find combos of x and y that produce a very small value of w. And similarly, once we get a value of w that's really close to 2, there are relatively few ways to combine x and y to get a value of w equals 2. But if we look at the value w equals 1, or something close to that, there's comparatively far more ways that we can combine x's and y's to get that value w equals 1. So in other words, values of w near 1 are going to be more likely than values of w closer to 0 or 2. All right, so in this example here, the thing that will be a little bit tricky or something that we need to pay attention to is the bounds of our integration here. Because the PDF for x is positive between 0 and 1, the PDF for y is positive between 0 and 1, and the PDF for w is positive between 0 and 2. So we're going to split this into two cases, actually. We're going to look at values of w between 0 and 1, and then next we're going to look at values of w between 1 and 2. And then one thing just to remind you of before we get started, since x and y are both uniformly distributed on the interval 0, 1, what that means is our PDF is equal to 1 for x values between 0 and 1, and 0 otherwise. Similarly, our PDF for y is equal to 1 for values of y between 0 and 1, and 0 otherwise. OK, so let's go ahead and start applying this theorem here. So first we'll look at this case, w is between 0 and 1. So if we have a small value of w, we're looking just in this interval 0 to 1 here. We have a small value of w. In order to make sure that our PDF for y is positive, the thing that we need to make sure of is that y is above 0. Because if y is below 0, then y is going to have a PDF value equal to 0. So we want to make sure that our PDF for y is positive. So we're going to focus on making sure that y values are going to be large enough, meaning y needs to be greater than 0. So we need to make sure y is greater than or equal to 0, but y is equal to w minus x. So really, we need to make sure that w minus x is greater than or equal to 0. And this is the same thing as making sure that w is greater than or equal to x. Okay, so why does this matter? It matters because this is going to define the bounds of our integration. So now when we set up this integral here, when we plug in our PDFs, so we'll have 1 and 1, what we're going to integrate between is x values going from 0 up to just w. Again, this is to make sure that our PDF for Y is positive. All right, so therefore our PDF for W is equal to the integral from 0 to W of dx, which is just equal to W. So therefore our PDF for W, when W is between 0 and 1, is just equal to W. Now let's look at case 2, where we have W between 1 and 2. So when we have relatively large values of W, values between 1 and 2, the thing that we need to make sure of is that Y is not going above 1, because if Y is going above 1, then our PDF for Y is going to be 0. So we want to keep our PDF positive, so we need to make sure that Y is less than or equal to 1. Okay, so if Y has to be less than or equal to 1, what does that mean? It means W minus X must be less than or equal to 1. And now if we solve for X, because we're trying to figure out the bounds of integration, and we're integrating with respect to X, then that means that X must be greater than or equal to W minus 1. All right, so now we have our bounds of integration. X is going to go from W minus 1 up to 1. So we integrate from W minus 1 up to 1, and our PDF is 1 for X and 1 for Y, and then we have dx. And so this is equal to X evaluated at 1 and W minus 1, so 1 minus W plus 1, which is equal to 2 minus W. All right, so we figured out case 1 and case 2, so that means that our PDF for W is equal to W when W is between 0 and 1. It's equal to 2 minus W when W is between 1 and 2, and it's equal to 0 otherwise. So if we wanted to draw a little picture of this PDF, it would look like this triangle here. So here's our value W, and then on this axis we have f of W, and so we can see that we have a line with slope W up until the point W equals 1, and then at that point W equals 1, then we have a line with slope negative W going downwards until 2, and then our PDF is 0 everywhere else.